Ladies and gentlemen, welcome inside the MGM Grand here in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. This is Boxing. This is Top Rank, presented by Hall of Fame boxing promoter Mr. Bob Arum. This bout is scheduled for 10 rounds for the NABO and vacant WBC Continental America's welterweight titles. Our judges at ringside, Tim Cheatham, Patricia Morse-Jarman, and Steve Weisfeld. And the man in charge, Mr. Kenny Bayless. Ladies and gentlemen watching around the world, this is Boxing, this is Top Rank, and this is the main event! Fighting out of the blue corner, presented in association with Groupe Yvon Michel. He weighed in at 147 pounds, wearing black, blue, and white trunks. He brings a record of 34 wins with only one defeat, 23 victories by way of knockout. From Trois-Rivières, Quebec, Canada, he is the reigning NABO champion, Mikhail Zuski! Fighting out of the red corner, he weighed in at 146.5 pounds, wearing black and gold trunks. He brings a record of 21 wins, one loss, one draw, 17 wins by way of knockout. He is a two-time Olympian. He's a former world title challenger from Kaunas, Lithuania, Aegis Mean Machine Kavalyauskas!
No, back.
Unified.
Okay, fellas, everything looked good on both sides. We went over the rules in the dressing room. Again, I want to caution to keep this fight clean at all times, protect yourself at all times, and what I say, you must obey. Good luck to both of you. Touch them up.
And under the unified rules, there will be no three knockdown rule. Instant replay is available to the Nevada State Athletic Commission. There's no standing eight count. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. In case of an accidental foul, we go to the scorecards after four complete rounds. Technical decision if the accidental foul happens before four, and only the referee or doctor can stop the fight. And we invite you to be a part of tonight's crowd. Cheer along using Hear Me Cheer on any device and have your voice heard live during the fights. Or go to ESPN.HearMeCheer.com to participate. I'm Bernardo Osuna alongside Timothy Bradley, and Mark Kriegel is also in the bubble. We're missing Joe Tessitore and Andre Ward, but tonight's main event features Aegis Kavalyauskas taking on Mikhail Zuski. Lithuania versus Canada. Both fighters ranked within the top 10 of, their governing bodies, but the road to a world title at welterweight, Tim.
It's tough.
You need to be impressive.
It's tough. You got to be impressive. Yeah. I mean, there's a fleet of top fighters at the welterweight division. You know, I'm going to just warn everybody right now. Don't go too far away from your TV. You know, if you're watching and you know someone else that like boxing, call them up right now and let them know to watch this fight, because both these guys have punching power in both hands. They can hurt each other at any moment in this fight.
Zuski's got 23 knockouts in his 34 wins, and Kavalyauskas has 17 knockouts in 21 wins. Another thing to watch out for is that Kavalyauskas has been cut in his last three fights, so that's something to watch out for.
All right, I'm gonna let you know. Another thing is that look for Kavalyauskas to land the right hand over the top of the jab of Zuski. You saw what just happened. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
And also, the punch of choice for Zuski is the left hook. He likes to get in position to land his left hook.
Zuski looks big tonight too. He's got that broad back from that camera angle. It's pretty impressive, but I was going to tell you, man, Kavalyauskas looks like Captain America. You know, got that nicely done hair, the abs, just put a shield right there. Nice right hand from Zuski and the quick cobra-like left with those venom gloves from Kavalyauskas. Both guys feeling each other out because there's a lot of respect for their respective power.
You saying feeling each other out? But these boys in there throwing leather. They getting to it.
They want to know just how hard the other guy hits with that body shot, which was low, according to referee Kenny Bayless here.
Yeah, neither of these guys, they're here for business. Neither of these guys are waiting or wasting any time to get in their rhythm.
There's that uppercut from Kavalyauskas.
That was a nice uppercut. Very well placed. They slipped in the inside. You know, most of the time when you slip a jab, you want to go to your right and then come over with the right hand. But he went in the inside, switched it up, and came up with the beautiful uppercut. For Kavalyauskas.
Round two of a scheduled 10-round main event here at the MGM Grand Bubble in Las Vegas. And it almost seems like a Mount Rushmore of fighters back there who were on today's card. All in prime shape here for the bubble. My, how things have changed over the last 10 weeks here in the bubble. I'm not alone anymore. I'm here with Timothy Bradley alongside Mark Kriegel as well. I'm Bernardo Osuna. And here we have Kavalyauskas and Michael Zuski. Mikhail Zuski exchanging leather. And one of the things we talked about is how is Kavalyauskas going to come back? Is his confidence going to be shaken? And I think it's the opposite. He grew from that fight, from being in the fight, from laying hands on Terence Crawford before being taken out and walked down. But his early success makes him feel like, I belong amongst the elite.
You know, I asked the question during the fighter meeting. I said, what did you think to yourself when you sat down, you know, after the first round and facing Terence Crawford? He said, it was easy. He couldn't believe it. It was easy. You know, and I have to say that, you know, when I was fought Manny Pacquiao for the first time, I said to myself, I belong. I belong in there with them. I can compete with this man.
And then you went on to get those great victories after that, because it's a confidence builder.
Even
if you don't get that win, which you did in the first fight, but nonetheless, it just gives you the fact that, man, I've been in there against one of the top dogs, not just in the division, but pound for pound. And not only that, to one of the meanest cats in the world when you talk about boxers and Terence Crawford. Mm. And you didn't ask him what he felt after the eighth round or the ninth round, which is smart, but hey, you got to take something out of those experiences.
No, you do. You take a lot out of those experiences. You know, I always say, man, suffering your first loss, you know, it can be challenging. You know, but boxing is 90% mental. You know, that's where your pride is tarnished. Your confidence is tarnished, you know. But what changed that is the fact that you go back, you review the tape, and you make some changes in your career. You make some adjustments. And, you know, and that's the thing that uplifts your pride and get you back in there.
And the changes that Kavalyauskas made was in terms of conditioning. He changed the way he was conditioning from before the Terence Crawford fight. And we'll see as this fight progresses if that made a difference. The pandemic's been tough on a lot of fighters, but he says, I kept myself in shape. Once again, the abs are all there. You know about that. I have no idea what it feels like to have those abs.
Man,
but
abs don't make you fight.
Trust
me, abs don't give you more skill.
Julio Cesar Chavez, who I did a show with, told me, look, I never had abs until now that I'm 50 years old. But you know what? I didn't need him to be the best in history from Mexico. So far, 23 jabs landed from Kavalyauskas compared to 9 jabs landed for his opponent, Mikhail Zuski.
You see the adjustment right there that Zuski just made. He's throwing the left hook. He wants him to keep the right hand home. That's what he wants Kavalyauskas to do, keep the right hand home. And plus, he understands now that's the shot. He understands that's the shot that Kavalyauskas is looking for, is the right hand. So he picked his hand up. Good adjustment.
What's the feeling in Egas's corner right now?
Well, Marco Contreras says Egas has to be busier. He's got to follow with that jab, a right hand over the top. As Zuski keeps his left hand down, he's there for the overhand right.
Mm-hmm. So right here, you know, the thing that I'm seeing right now is that Zuski has better footwork. He has better footwork than Kavaiaskis. Kavaiaskis, he got the wide stance. What is he doing? He just, you know, he's been beached like a whale. He's sitting directly in front, trying to counterpunch. You know, no adjustments. It's easy for Zuski to get in and get out with his punches.
That's a nice big shot that Zuski landed on Kavaiaskis, kind of woke him up a little bit. And Kavaiaskis comes back with the left hook and down goes to the body in Mikhail Zuski. So it's becoming a high-level power chess match here at the center of the ring.
Yes, it is. Both these guys are power boxers.
Work out. Stop. Sit back.
Look, it doesn't look like Kavaiaskis is doing much, but he is. You know, he's trying to wear the young man, wear the younger man down by applying pressure, occasionally shooting the jab down the middle, and then just catching his punches off his guard, making them work. Then eventually he's gonna step it up.
And you see the work with the 1-2, but the two goes down to the body and not upstairs for Mikhail Zuski.
See, the problem I'm having with Kavaiaskis right now is a beautiful jab, but where is the right hand? Where's the cleanup proof? That jab is so problematic right now for Zuski.
I mean, he can't get away from it, but you mentioned there's only that one shot. There's nothing following up behind it here as we come to the conclusion of round. Zuski not even breathing hard there after that third round.
No, Zuski's not breathing hard, but I saw a little bit of transition, you know, a little bit of, what do you call it? I saw a change in Zuski. A small change in that last round. I saw Kavaiaskis get a little bit more aggressive, have success with the jab. It seems like he has found the key finally.
The question is, will he follow the instructions of Marco Contreras, who wants something behind that jab as opposed to just that stick forward? You see a little bit of inflammation under the right eye of Egas Kavaiaskis, and that's the jab that Zuski's had some success with as well, and the left hook.
And that thing swelled up really fast. I don't know if it's from the left hook or maybe a thumb in the eye. But it's quickly swelling. It's swelling very fast.
It is. You get that mouse right underneath it, and it's nice right hand there from Zuski. And this is becoming a firefight. Both guys have power, and they're giving us the fireworks early on here in their 10 round match.
Listen, it don't feel like a sparring session to me. These boys trying to take each other head off.
Well, maybe that's why it feels more like a sparring match, because sometimes, you know, it's like, hey, let's take it easy today. We're just gonna work on this, and once somebody gets cracked, it's on. Kavaiaskis will have Mike the Mechanic Basil working on that inflamed right eye once round four comes to an end, and he's going to have his work cut out for him.
Better get that inswell ready.
You see that chess match. It's the footwork, but also just keeping an eye on each other where that power shot is coming from, because there you see that stick jab from Kavaiaskis, his best weapon so far. But he's not setting anything else up behind it. He must be respecting that left hook of Zuski.
Listen, I don't know what he's respecting, but right now, Zuski's outworking him right now, outlanding him and outworking him at this moment.
They say styles make fights, and it's impressive to think that Kavaiaskis was looking better against Terrence Crawford through the first four rounds than he's looking against Zuski.
Well, it's just styles make fights. That's all it is. I think, honestly, Terrence Crawford, I think they thought something different. I think that they thought that he was going to bring pressure. Let's put it that way.
Inflammation on the right eye. I push it away from the eyeball of Egas Kavaiaskis. And, you know, they were pretty precise in terms of the instructions. Marco Contreras saying, look, these rounds are very, very close. You're doing very good work with the jab. And then Edgar Cruz chiming in, but you got to use that right hand as well. Mark, what do you got?
Mike Basil, esteemed cut man, says it's not too much of a problem. It's under the eye. Just a mouse, fellas.
Just a mouse becomes an issue very quickly if it's not handled well, but one of the best in the business, Mike Basil here. We've got three cut men working the corners, and Calvayasca's Drew Basil, while Michael Zuski has Stitch Duran working in that corner, so both guys in good hands.
See, every time Calvayasca's getting his rhythm, you know, and let his hands go, he's dictating the pace and also the action. About 10 seconds ago, I saw a left hook that landed to the body of Zuski, and he reacted a certain way. It hurt him. And seeing that, that's where I'm going.
There you see, that's exactly what Kamalioska saw. He's like, look, I'm going to go to the body with the left and then the right hand. So
he must have saw the same thing that I saw, the way that Zuski reacted to those body shots.
The problem is he's got to get inside that jab to be able to land to the body. And Zuski being able to control range at times.
Oh, he's getting in there. His jab, Kabayaskis' jab is landing. Look at that. Bop, bop. He just need to get his head outside, get his foot outside to be able to land the left hook to the body.
See that right hand from Zuski just barely got off the line, did Kabayaskis. Ooh, nice body shot there from Zuski.
That was a good one. That's the key right there, the body work. The body work is the key for Calvayasca right now. If he continues to go down to the body, he's going to break down Zuski.
Zuski's got that same idea.
Zuski now dropping the hand. I always say you got to know why you're dropping the hand. You know, it better not just be you want to look cool. There need to be a reason. You're trying to lower in something.
Calvayasca's is very clear in saying, look, I know that none of the PBC champions are going to give me an opportunity. I have to basically break down the door, beat contender after contender, and that's the only way I'm ever going to get another shot at the world title. And so far, he's been consistent. Already called him to ask about a thumb injury that he had. He said, hey, I'm ready to go. I'm recovered. So, you know, it's one of those things where he hasn't shown any ill effects of that thumb injury. He's in this fight in round six. A scheduled 10-round fight against Vegas Calvayasca. I'm Bernardo Osuna alongside Timothy Bradley and Mark Kriegel coming to you live from the bubble. It's good to have you guys here present. How does it feel to see the fights again, Tim?
Oh, it feels great. You know, you can see a lot more when you're sitting right in front. You know, you can feel the impact of these punches. Wow.
Like that quick combination from Mikael Zuski that makes Calvayasca take a step back.
Yeah, you know, sitting in my house inside that small little office, you know, I had to do what I had to do. It wasn't fun, I tell you that. I enjoy being here with you, Bernardo, tonight.
I'm glad you're not watching this on an iPad. Mark, you were in the corner of Mikael Zuski. What does his father, Jean, say?
Jean Zuski, father and coach. I asked him, what about those right hooks of Kavalowski? He says, it doesn't matter. I want my son to attack the eye, close that eye.
Hey, that's the art of war, especially in boxing. And Tim, what's it like when you see a vulnerability like that that just glares at you?
You just can't fully commit to it. Of course, you want to continue to hit that eye. But if you just commit to that and focus on that, you can lose track of the fight in the game plan.
Calvayasca's had success with the right to the body, and here with a nice overhand right. Here's the exchange and the quickness of Mikael Zuski, but now you see the pressure, the bully come out in Calvayasca's, and this is where he's dangerous.
This is exactly where he's dangerous, and right now he has Zuski on his heels right now.
Taking a book out of that Terrence Crawford playbook. I'm going to let you do your thing early on, and then it's my turn. Let's see how you react.
That's that experience. Experience comes in late in fights.
You can see the tide turning here with Kavalioskas getting a lot more comfortable, taking a step forward. And Zuski now trying to figure out, how do I get this guy off me? There you see that stick jab, follows up with that right hand.
Good body shot right there from Zuski, stepping inside again to land that shot high on the hip. Again, the biggest difference here is just the fact that Kavalioskas is, he's leading. He's marching forward. He's being aggressive. He's being the boss. That's when he is effective.
Twice as many jabs as Mikhail Zuski at a 30% clip, but the way to win this fight convincingly and do what everybody expects him to do in terms of win in an impressive fashion, to demand a world title shot, it has to be the follow-up punches, not just that jab.
You got to show a sense of urgency. I saw a little bit in that last round, you know, but I want to continue to see the dominance, you know, not no back and forth action. No, you have to dominate these rounds, especially these later rounds.
You see that right hand by Mikhail Zuski, who's still a dangerous puncher. I mean, he's got 23 knockouts at a 66% clip of his win, so he's in this fight.
Oh, nice shot. That left hook right there staggered Kavalioskas. He was a little bit off balance, but I have to say he was buzzed.
We'll see how he reacts here. Kavalioskas coming forward once again. You see the head movement from Mikhail Zuski. Zuski, and you see that right hand drops him again here at the start of round eight, and the fight is over.
That was fast.
Hey, Tim, here in the bubble, we
done.
Wow, impressive finish. That's what we talked about. Egis Kavalioskas needs to make a statement and prove that he deserves a world title shot, and that's exactly what he did in the last two rounds.
That's what I was talking about, coming through the side door. Now, you know, it's time to show out. It's been a long time since we've seen this type of performance and knockout from Kavalioskas, and he got it. He did it in great fashion. Like I said, check his temperature, come out. He hurt him at the end of that last round, and he came out and checked him early and jumped on him early. He came around the guard right there, landed right on the chin of Zuski. That sent him to the canvas and ended the fight. Here it is again. Beautiful setup, just follow up. He knew he had his man hurt. He used his experience tonight. You know, he was patient tonight. He used a great jab tonight. You know, to set up this punch, the uppercut. Beautiful, beautiful shot right there from Kavalioskas. Great finish, great performance. He showed a lot of experience. He showed a lot of experience tonight. You know, in the beginning, you know, he let Zuski, you know, go ahead and work. Okay, go ahead and work. I'm just going to slowly walk you down and break you down. I'm going to catch some shots. Yeah, you might hit me, but I'm going to hit you back. And when I do hit you, I'm going to hurt you. And then he set him up for that uppercut. That wasn't a lucky shot. He set him up. He waited on him to jab down to the body, and then he lifted him up with the right uppercut, which caused the problem, which caused trouble, which wreaked havoc on Zuski. And then the follow-up shots right there you saw, and ended the fight. What a beautiful performance by Kavalioskas. Congratulations.
If I take you back to December 14, it was him playing the part of Terrence Crawford against Egis Kavalioskas. And, you know, the CompuBox numbers don't lie. I mean, the total punches both landed at about a 30-plus percent clip, but it was those power shots from Egis Kavalioskas that really took him to victory. The official time of the knockout with Mark Chinook.
Ladies and gentlemen, here inside MGM Grand, this bout comes to a halt at 7 seconds of round number eight for your winner by knockout, and now NABO and WBC Continental America's champion, Egis Mean Machine K.